back. We are on part two of TSW Train Sim World 2. We are running the LDG-51 route from Thompson to 7 Mile. And this is the SD40-2 Union Pacific diesel electric locomotive. We are pulling 44 cars, 1611.6 tons and 815 yards of train. All right, guys, we are down to 8.4 miles now. We're doing pretty good. And we're starting to slow down. Let's go ahead and speed up here. Get back up to our 25. So once we get down here, we're going to have some more work to do. We're going to have dropped some cars off along the way, it looks like. So that means stepping down and stepping off the train, uncoupling cars, repositioning, all that good stuff. All right, we're gonna need to hit throttle four here. Just upgrade, this incline's getting a little steep. We are slowly getting back up to 25. I'm not going to push it too much. Just leave it at 4. Let the train do most of the work. Well, that incline went to 1.1. It's getting steeper. Got to 5 here for a minute. Just as quickly as it goes up, it can go down just as fast. So you gotta stay ready. Gotta be ready. All right, we got a crossing coming up here. Let's go ahead and blow our warning. Give off our warning, let any traffic know we're coming. Long train. See, now we're over speeding, so let's go ahead and slow down. I didn't realize it because I'm in the back of the train here watching it go by. Are we back down underneath the speed limit? Alright, we're down to 6.5 miles. We're making our way slowly but surely, tugging along. Let's go ahead and drop the throttle down to 3. Make sure we're not over speeding. All right, we got a little incline here, so we're gonna need dynamic braking here. Set that to 4. Move it up to 5 if we need to, and I think we're going to need to do that. You see what I mean about it's just as quickly as you're going up a hill, it's just like that. It'll change on you. Gotta be ready. Let's move it up to 6 to keep it under 25. Now the train acting like it want to fight me a little bit. You gotta remain in control at all times. It felt like I almost got loose, man. A couple trains almost got loose on me. It was very hard for me to get them back under control, but somehow, some way, I imagine. But I understand for real engineers, that has to be a scary situation. All right, we got 4.5 miles before we get to King Creek Branch. And then we'll be preparing for our 7 mile approach where we'll probably have to stop along the way and unhook some consists along the way. But that's not too much of a big deal. I'm very familiar with yard work. They make you do a lot of it, so you get good with it. Yard work is not my favorite thing to do in this game, but it is a part of the job, so I do it. I get it done. Begrudgingly. All right, let's apply a little more dynamic brake here. Start the speed. That tower right there is actually a little airport that's situated there. I forget the name. Let's bring up the map real quick. I think the name of it is actually up here. Yeah, Canyonlands Field Airport. That's the airport that's there. A little small local airport. I'm probably sure it supports nothing but, you know, little small private planes and things of that nature. I don't even think it's big enough for like cargo to land. I could be wrong. Okay, I had to ease up on the dynamic braking because we were starting to slow down a little too much. Alright, in case anybody's wondering, because I know I'm kind of doing this with the keyboard, the dynamic brakes are situated here. These are your full train brakes here, and well, they're full for the whole train. And then you have your independent brake, which is just for the locos. They'll stop the locos. In serious situations, you could kind of use all three of them together. In real life, I'm not sure if that would like totally burn out a system or whatever. However that works, but I know in game, I've had to do it a few times. Yeah, I definitely had to. All right, we're down to 3.2 miles. We're slowly making our way there. And there's the airport there coming up on our right. Canyonlands Field. Ease up on this dynamic braking a little more. The incline is only at 0.3%, so slowing down a little bit too much. It would be cool if there was like a plane or something there or landing, so we kind of take a look as we're going by. I don't see much. I see car activity. I don't see any planes. I don't see planes out on the runway parked anywhere. If they are, I definitely don't see them. We had to increase our dynamic braking. We actually need to increase it a little bit more. It's up to 1%, back down to 0.9. Miles. Once we get there, we'll get the next step on what we should be doing next. Let's blow this horn for this little crossing here. Alright, we can definitely tune down our dynamic braking, so it's almost a flat surface. We'll leave it on setup just in case we need to reapply it again. Yeah, so sometimes I usually have another individual in the second man seat over there, but I guess, oh, look at the overspeeding. We just use the brake to deal with that. I didn't realize that. I was so busy running my mouth. All right, we can go back to neutral now. That's why I don't like hitting the train brake, because it actually slows the train down way more than you need it to. But in that situation, I was just like, wow, I was overspeeding a few miles over. Wanted to get under that as soon as possible. We'll hit 24 and then I'll start to throttle down. Yeah, see, we're starting to go downhill again. So let's go ahead and set up our dynamic brake here. we'll actually start to apply some because we're at 0.8. Bring it up to file. Who's still gathering speed? I'm sure that's the weight of the cars behind us. Even though we're now on level track, the rest of the train isn't, so we're still gonna need to hold the brakes for a little while so the rest of the train reaches level track. Wow, that's like a big, major piece of rock there just landing the track. I like, stuff like that, man, that stuff should have been corrected. There's no way there should be stuff like that. This thing has been out for a while. All right, the conductor says we have to set out a 10 empty stone hoppers at the siding at 7 mile. Let's stop on the main line track to begin our work there. All right, so when we get to 7 mile, 4.2 miles away, we'll have to start unhooking. We'll have to unhook 10 cars and drop them off. Alright guys, we're down to about 3.5 miles here. right, we're down to 2.5 miles here. Let me ease up on the, actually we can go ahead and set up on the train, not the train, but the dynamic brake since we're on level ground. Alright, we're gonna need to increase throttle a lot because this is a 1.5% incline here. So we're gonna need to add a lot of throttle. Okay guys, that is going to do it for part 2. I appreciate y'all all for coming through and checking out the video. Guys, make sure you hit that subscribe button if you're not a subscriber. Also hit the like button and also hit that notification bell so you know when I'm posting my next video. Guys, I appreciate y'all for coming through. Stay sucker free, stay COVID free, and I'll see you guys in part 3. Peace.